principal at LaSalle Middle School, and we have Conchita Ramirez here, helping us use our family liaison, and she'll be sharing everything in Spanish tonight as well.
Okay, bienvenidos a los estudiantes que van a ser de quinto grado, dice ella de que no puede creerlo verlos aquí, cuando los ven segundo grado, pasan a perder tiempo y les da la bienvenida.
So we're going to spend a little bit of time here together with the fifth grade teachers, sharing with you some of the new things about middle school, and then they'll take you down to the fifth grade pod, we call it, which is the area where all of their classrooms are, and the learning area in the middle, and you'll get a chance to see what the classrooms look like and get your schedules at that time.
Van a estar aquí los maestros del quinto grado, vamos a hablar un poco de lo que hace cada una, después nos vamos a reunir en el área del quinto grado, y ya cada estudiante con su papá puede hablar con cada maestra para platicar acerca de lo que es y cómo trabaja el quinto grado.
So first I want to let you know that you are very normal if you are excited and nervous, both the kids and the parents. This is a big transition, and we understand that. And so we're going to try to do whatever we can to support you, both the kids and the parents, through that transition.
Dice que vamos a ayudarles a tanto los padres como los estudiantes con esta transición. Es una transición muy normal, no tienes por qué preocuparse ni por qué estar nervioso.
Having been both a fifth grade teacher and the assistant principal of elementary school, I have a better understanding now of what that transition really means. I remember hearing the kids always say they loved middle school so much because there's so much freedom, and I just didn't understand that because to me it felt like we were super strict. But I think the difference now, having been at the elementary, when you start off in kindergarten, you have to learn how to walk in a line. It's really important for safety reasons. And as you start to develop and get to the place where you are ready for fifth grade, you don't have to walk in lines anymore because you know how to keep your hands to yourself, you know how to walk carefully and travel from place to place, and really take care of yourself more. And you're taking more ownership of your behaviors and your learning. So that's really what freedom feels like because you've developed the responsibility to earn those freedoms in middle school.
Claro, lo que ella dijo, no voy a poder traducir exactamente como ella dijo, ¿verdad? Pero dice que teniendo ya la experiencia de que ella fue maestra aquí de, por varios años aquí en el quinto grado, después fue la subdirectora del elementary, ¿verdad? Cuando los niños estaban en el kinder, ustedes veían de que ellos estaban caminando en la línea, pues, guardando sus manos, caminando con sus manos guardadas, ¿verdad? Y dice de que ella escuchaba de que ellos querían estar en la middle school porque tenían más libertad, pero ella no entiende por qué quieren tener más libertad.
So we do expect to be able to give you freedoms based on your behaviors of responsibility. And that's a big difference, I think, as a parent to send your kid to middle school because there are a lot more things that the teachers are communicating to the students that they're expecting the students to take responsibility of. So there is that little bit more ownership that we put on the students' shoulders in fifth grade. And the communication, we ask that you communicate with the teachers, but we also ask that the parents talk to their students and encourage their students to voice their own needs to their teachers as well and try to start training the kids to be that advocate for their own needs. Okay. We're talking about ownership. The transition to middle school, really the ownership starts to come more on the kids' shoulders, and we encourage the parents to coach the kids to talk to their teachers about it.
Okay. Dicen que ella les anima a los padres para que hablen con sus estudiantes, ¿verdad? Para que hablen con los maestros y que no sientan una carga pesada en sus hombros y que siempre tengan esa comunicación con ellos.
So along with that, we do send weekly newsletters and have a website and Facebook, and I know Allison will talk a little bit more about all of those communications, as well as robocalls that we call each week for academics, and we send some frequent reminders about behaviors if your student is not quite meeting the expectations.
Okay, cada semana nosotros mandamos por email la carta que se hace por semana para la información de lo que está ocurriendo en el curso. Tenemos Alison, que es la encargada del sistema de comunicación, y también mandamos llamadas acerca de la conducta de los estudiantes, y si el estudiante no alcanzó a los estándares que debería haber alcanzado, si le faltó trabajo que entregar, y ver cómo está trabajando.
A big thing here at the middle school that we've supported for many years is called the growth mindset, which means that we know that kids and adults, we're all learning, and we expect there to be mistakes. And it's part of our goal to try to learn from our mistakes and to grow and make better decisions or learn new strategies for whatever skill we're trying to apply next time. So that's something that you should hear a lot from us. If a student says, I can't, then we say,
yes.
Yet. Because we're trying to help them see that potential in themselves and that you are always learning and growing, and it's okay to make mistakes.
La manera que el sistema que se usa aquí, ¿verdad? Es acerca de que el estudiante, cuando piense que no puede hacerlo, siempre hay otro pensamiento, ¿verdad? De que sea abierto, de que no lo puede hacer ahorita, pero más adelante lo va a alcanzar. Ellos están conscientes, ¿verdad?, de que muchas veces se aprende a base de errores, y es la razón por la que ellos están animando a los estudiantes para que siempre estén tratando, y así lo van a lograr.
And so our vision as a school, we teach the kids this motto: work hard, be nice, and achieve. And the achieve part is really that growth that you make from working hard, and the be nice part is what creates that welcoming, belonging kind of culture that we have here at the South School.
Okay, es que trabajamos con tres palabras, que es trabajar duro y que sean agradables, que sean agradables, ¿verdad? Y que estén siempre pensando en el desafío. Con estas tres palabras que les siempre en mente y siempre están trabajando sobre eso para que logren sus objetivos.
And we have some new policies this year that we are implementing. We have had honor roll and Longhorn Pride for many years, and we have just made those standards a little bit more rigorous. In order to be on, the report card is the same as elementary. You have academic grades, and you have habits of a scholar grades. And in order to get the honor of Longhorn Pride, you need to have all of your habits grades a 3 or a 4, meaning you're meeting the expectation or exceeding it. And then in your academic grades, they can be 2s, 3s, or 4s, because we want to honor you for the hard work. And sometimes we don't have the skills yet.
Okay, dice que es un poco diferente a lo que sus estudiantes venían haciendo en la escuela primaria. Aquí hay dos premios que se les da cada 3 meses. Es sobre All Honor y Longhorn Pride. Para que ellos puedan obtener el Longhorn Pride, ellos necesitan en sus hábitos de estudio tener grados o calificaciones como el 3 y 4.
And the other one is called Honor Roll, and that's for all 3s and 4s, both in the habits of a scholar and in the academics.
En el Honor Roll es lo mismo, ¿verdad? Tienen que tener más bien 3 y 4s en tanto los hábitos como en lo académico.
So I just wanted to make sure we talked about that. Plus, it's in the student's planner that they'll get on the first day of school, all of our policies. And we do have another new policy, our diversity policy, that just states that we honor all students from all walks of life, and we want to make sure that we set up an environment where all students feel accepted and that they belong as a part of our community. So that is a new policy.
Bueno, al principio del año escolar se les va a dar a los niños un plan, una agenda, ¿verdad?, donde ellos anotan cada día todas sus clases. Y la otra póliza, es acerca de la diversidad, donde todos los estudiantes se sienten que ellos son aceptados aquí dentro de esta comunidad.
And the other new policy is a cell phone policy, and that is that cell phones will not be used by students during school hours, from 8 to 3:15. We ask that those cell phones be either kept at home or in their locker or in their backpack. And if they are going to keep it in their locker, they need to make sure that they don't share their locker combination with other people, and they don't put a pencil in to make the locker easily open because other people will get in there. So they need to be, if they bring that property to school, they need to be careful with being responsible for it because they can't use it during the school day.
Otra de las nuevas políticas que ya existe en escuela, ¿verdad? Es hacer desde el uso del teléfono celular. El teléfono celular no se va a poder usar de las 8:05 a las 10:15, en lo que van a estar aquí en escuela. Ya de ustedes depende si prefiere que lo dejen en la casa o lo puede traer su estudiante aquí a la escuela, pero tiene que estar seguro de ponerlo en su locker y que no comparta con nadie su combinación para que no se lo vayan a robar, pues así directamente. Y o que vayan a ponerle así como una pista más para que pase donde van a poner la y que pongan más lápiz para que pase, porque están expuestos a que se les pierda el teléfono.
So if you need to get a hold of your student during the school day, or if you have a message you want your student to get, please call the office and they will, there's a message board in the foyer. They'll put a slip out on that board and the kids need to double check that board if they aren't sure what they're supposed to do after school or if they needed to get a message from their parents. It'll be on that board. If it's more of an emergency, the office will get a hold of your student for you.
Okay, did you say van a llamar a la oficina, ahí van a dejar el mensaje, el mensaje lo vamos a escribir, lo vamos a poner aquí en este pasillo, aquí está un pizarrón, donde se ponen los mensajes, entonces de los estudiantes ustedes, va a haber algún cambio para el final del día que no saben exactamente qué es lo que va a hacer su estudiante, ellos pueden venir a checar durante su receso que tienen, pueden venir a checar a ver si tienen algún mensaje, pero de esa manera ellos se van a dar cuenta de qué es lo que van a necesitar hacer después de la escuela.
And then the final policy we didn't change, but I just want to make sure that we share it with you as new students in our school, is the dress code policy. And that is just really set up to dress for respect and to, this is kind of like your place of business. And so we want to give you some standards for that place of business and the work that you do at school. So we have a couple of rules. You can't wear shirts that have things like anything that's inappropriate. Drugs, alcohol, guns, no shirts that have any of that on it that's inappropriate. Your shorts, if you're wearing shorts, they have to be longer than your fingertips, not like this, but like this. And I know that's hard because I've been shopping in those stores too, it's really hard. But you need to make sure that you save those short shorts from home and after school, and when you're at school, have shorts and skirts that are longer than that. And then same with spaghetti straps. We had some issues with dances and stuff where girls were coming with the spaghetti strap dresses, and it's just one of our policies that it has to be at least 2 fingers long on the straps. I want to make sure we do that so that as you're school shopping that you don't get stuck with something that you'll have to change when you come to school.
Otra policía que ya aquí en la escuela, verdad, es sobre el código de vestir. Como digo, ella, verdad, que no está permitido que traigan playeras que traigan aquí, por ejemplo, pintados como cigarros, como botellas de flor o la flor de la marihuana, ¿verdad? Dice ella de que también para los shorts tienen que medirse las manos para que el short no quede más arriba donde lleguen las manos y que tampoco los niños traigan camisetas sin mangas o las niñas traigan también blusas con tirantes bien delgaditos. De otra manera, también algunas veces hemos tenido que llevar a los estudiantes a que se cambien aquí en las cosas que están aquí en perdidas, que de pronto estudiantes, pero si las hacen que se cambien.
So I just want to leave you with I guess I already shared our school model, which was, do you remember what it was? Work hard, be nice, and achieve. Good job. Get some good people. All right, I would like to introduce to you some of the people who will be available to help throughout your years here at the Salt Middle School. You can come to me, Mr. Hayden's sister, can come to him. We also have Marlon Funes here, who's our counselor.
Hi, my name is Marlon Funes, and I come from Denver. It's great to be here. Counselor, and we're working with your students. We help with supporting the students with their social emotional goals, their career goals, and academic goals. So this is the gist of what I'm going to be doing. When Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Marlon Funes, he llegado de Denver, recién llegado de Denver. Yo aquí estoy, soy un consejero y voy a trabajar con sus estudiantes para ayudarles a que puedan alcanzar las metas de las académicas, sentimental y también de las carreras. Y entonces por eso estoy para ayudarles.
And we have Allison Johnson also, who is our communications liaison and the person who works with students in the Makerspace, which is an awesome space available at lunch.
I'm practicing my growth mindset today because last year I was too quiet. So if you can't hear me in the back, just raise your hand and I will shout even louder. At Basalt Middle School, we really value parent input. We really value parents as a part of the learning community. 4 years ago, I was in your seat. My son is just going off to high school now. And my role is partly to do the communications for the school. We have a newsletter that goes out by email on Fridays. We have a website that's got tons of information. So if you have questions about some of the things Jennifer mentioned, growth mindset, policies, procedures, homework help, all these different things you're going to hear about tonight, they're all listed on the website. We also do chat points. We also do Facebook. If you don't like Facebook, we have a news feed on the website, so you can read that way as well. Part of what I do is go around and really try and capture for you what's going on in your students' day. It's really important when you get those registration packets to make sure your email addresses and your phone numbers are all up to date, because we will be contacting you really regularly through those sources. And then we also have, you know, if you want to learn about growth mindset, go to the website. We have some great information specifically for parents to help you understand what we're doing in the school.
Okay, ya les, ¿verdad? Si una directora que reciba los paquetes, les conviene que venga a sus hijos y les dan un paquete. Ahí va toda la información y van muchas formas que ustedes tienen que llenar y tienen que regresar. En esa forma ustedes tienen que poner su correo electrónico porque es una de las maneras de que nos comunicamos con ustedes. Y si han cambiado de teléfono o de correo electrónico, por favor, para que lo pongan, para poderlo tener al día en nuestra computadora, para que ustedes reciban toda la información que mandamos. Si alguien no tiene correo electrónico, pueden hablar conmigo para ver cómo lo podemos tomar.
We're also always looking for volunteers, so please contact us. My contact information is on the website. Anyone here can help you, but we love volunteers for a lot of different opportunities. There's fundraisers, there's band boosters, there's Makerspace. I also work in the Makerspace. We're always looking for donations. If you're getting rid of Lego, please don't bring them to the thrift store. Bring them to us. We have a great facility in the cafeteria where kids can come in and make and design and create. It's got Minecraft, computers, Legos, games, all sorts of things in there. And we're always looking for donations for that as well. It's really fun.
Ya también trabajo con lo del espacio que está aquí, un cuarto que está aquí al frente de la cafetería. Los estudiantes ahí trabajan mucho con legos y con cosas de ciencia. Ella les ayuda